job, that we would not be safe to do our jobs, and that we would feel so helpless in that moment to protect our democracy. But I want the American public to remember that despite the fact that we were on the floor fearing for our lives, that we went back and we certified that election. And we certified Joe Biden and Kamala Harris as the president and vice president. Yes. I want people to know that we saved our democracy that night.
This was a vicious, violent, coordinated, planned attack on our democracy. And I think the American people are going to learn how close we came to losing our democracy.
I remember seeing many of those same Republicans running through the hallways afraid for their lives. So if their own lived experience isn't enough, I'm not sure there's anything that we can say or do that will change their mind. But the fact remains that what we saw today is that we were incredibly close to losing our democracy. We saw that it was probably seconds between when members of Congress were evacuated and when the insurrectionists were able to get to the hallways that they were in. And we saw that it was the decisions of a few people, people like Vice President Pence, people like General Milley, that really stood between a coup happening. And we talk about our institutions, we talk about how fragile our democracy is, but to see so clearly that it was the decisions of a few people that were the difference between having the democracy we have right now and having someone violently overtake the will of the people, I think it's really eye-opening.